Hey guys, this is Barry from Copper vs Glass, and today we're going to be taking a look at the Apex launcher for Android. Now, just as I reviewed previously and had a quick look at the Nova launcher, Apex launcher is just a way of changing the visual effects of your ice cream sandwich device to make it look like more pure ICS. Now, I'm using a Samsung Galaxy S2 here, running the Android ice cream sandwich, which has just come out, and I love it so far, but I don't really like Samsung's TouchWiz experience, so I thought I'd give it a bit of a change up. I use Nova Launcher for a bit, and I had a couple of comments on my video talking about how they prefer Apex, so I thought I'd check it out. Now, Apex, when I first installed it, the first thing I noticed was that it looked very, very similar in the look and feel and just the general app layout that was the same between Nova and Apex. As we go down here to the bottom, to click on the options button, we've got very similar settings. If we go down here to Apex settings, the settings page here almost looks exactly identical to Nova Launcher. It's very, very similar. You might not even know the difference if you were just to see them both side by side. You'd only really know just by the top here where it says Apex Launcher, and that's pretty much it. So we've got settings for things like home screen, changing the default number of home screens, grids, margins, scrolling effects, wallpaper effects, indicators, loads of options in here. Now, a lot of these options are things that will customize the experience further, but I've kept most of my options off just to have it very, very basic and closest to the pure Android experience as I can. Now, Apex Launch has just recently updated their app to support themes. Now, one of my gripes at the moment is that the theme support, I'm not entirely sure how it works. You can see here it says default theme here with icon pack, skin and font, and they say you can add themes from Go Launcher and other things like that, but I've found that if I download a theme that was from, for example, Go Launcher, I can't install it, I don't know how to use it, it's not very clear, so I wish that they would make that a little bit more clear to their users about how to actually apply themes, because I would very much like to change my icons to look like pure ICS instead of the TouchWiz icons. Apart from that, I think Apex Launcher is very, very good. I can't really say that it's too different to Nova Launcher to notice any real difference. The only difference I think that I have here is that in the app drawer, if I go to widgets, I now get a very good visual representation of the widgets. But because I haven't got a rooted device, if I try and add a widget from this page in the app drawer, it won't let me because it says I need root access to do so. So it's a bit of a pointless visual representation. It just looks quite nice, but it doesn't actually do a lot. You still have to add widgets in the traditional way. The app drawer, of course, is very, very nice with very seamless transitions here, good response. A couple of people said that on my last video for Nova Launcher, it was going a bit slow. Can't say I noticed that too much, but I haven't had any slowdown or anything like this from here. I have had, however, some issues very recently on my Galaxy S2. I'm not sure if other people have, basically the device crashing, applications freezing, force quitting, things like that. I've never rooted my device, I've never played about with it, so I can't think it's anything to do with that. Maybe it's just some bugs in ICS for the Galaxy S2, I'm not really sure. But yeah, Apex Launcher is very, very nice, and I think I'll be using it for the near future until probably my next device, which may be the Galaxy S3, who knows, or I'm probably just going to wait till the next Nexus device comes out, to be honest. So yeah, this is just a quick look at the Apex Launcher, and that's Barry from Copper vs Glass. I'll see you later.